The Salinas City Council joined 130 cities and counties statewide protesting the governor's proposal to try and seize their gas tax money. It's a move expected to cost Central Coast taxpayers millions, maybe for several years to come. Action News reporter Stephanie Trong is live in Salinas with details.
Dan, what's also unsettling in all of this is there's no guarantee on when these gas tax raids would end, and that would leave cities like Salinas here little choice but to lay off more workers, most of them, if not all, in public safety. Shootings in Salinas aren't confined only to the east part of town anymore. The most recent drive-by happened here in North Salinas by El Dorado Park, where Amanda Sepulveda and her husband take their kids to play. What keeps them going? They say police presence.
It does make me feel better because I see them all the time.
But that could change as early as this year. The city will be forced to lay off public safety workers if the governor's proposal to raid local gas tax funds is successful.
So it pays for everything, including cops and libraries and, you know, street systems and infrastructure.
Our whole balanced budget could be undone by what the state may or may not do.
Salinas would lose $1.5 million general fund dollars for at least the next 2 years. That means there could be more cuts to city services this year, even after Salinas workers agreed to $13 million worth of pay cuts. It gets worse for 2010-2011, when the gas tax raid would drive the budget deficit to $7.5 million.
It's a significant amount of money considering we have no reserves.
And that means more than 60 layoffs of full-time workers, all in the police and fire departments.
I mean, we can't afford to lay off any officers here in the police department, especially with our gang issues right now and our shootings. So if that were to happen, God, I mean, we're just going to give the city to the gangs.
That's horrible. That's a lot of people are going to, there's going to be a lot more violence, I think. And it really worries me about the fire because that people can lose their lives, I mean, anytime. Just for an accident.
Now, Salinas would also lose $1 million each year, this year and the next, in street repairs and maintenance money. Now, if this state gas tax raid does go through, Salinas could join several other cities in maybe suing the state. And we are using the word raid because right now there's no indication that the state would pay back any of this money. Dan?
Yeah, they're none too happy about it. Thanks very much, Stephanie. There are other public safety concerns arising from all of this. The Monterey County DA's office joined other district attorneys across the state condemning the governor's proposal of commuting sentences of criminal aliens, allowing them to be deported instead of serving their time.